Given an AI system that predicts patient readmission risks, which component is vital for enhancing its transparency and accountability? A. Exclusive reliance on proprietary algorithm SB, deployment without external audits C. Generation of model cards detailing its performance, biases, and datasets D. Avoiding disclosure of any limitations or potential biases to users. Correct answer. C. Generation of model cards detailing its performance, biases, and datasets. In developing an AI-driven financial advice platform, how should the team approach the integration of ethical AI principles to address potential biases? A. By limiting the diversity of the development team. B. Focusing solely on maximizing algorithmic efficiency. C. Incorporating a diverse set of stakeholder perspectives during the design phase, excluding feedback mechanisms for users to report issues. Correct answer. C. Incorporating a diverse set of stakeholder perspectives during the design phase. For an AI system designed to automate resume screening, what is a critical step to ensure it does not perpetuate existing biases? A. Utilizing only the datasets that were readily available and convenient. B. Conducting a thorough bias and fairness audit before deployment. C. Implementing the system quickly to maximize immediate operational efficiency. D. Disregarding the importance of transparency in the algorithm's decision-making process. Correct answer. B. Conducting a thorough bias and fairness audit before deployment. When designing an AI solution for urban traffic management, which of the following would best ensure the system's adaptability to real-world complexities and ethical considerations? A. Deploying the system based on initial simulations without real-world testing. B. Engaging only with automotive industry stakeholders. C. Integrating continuous feedback loops from a wide range of urban stakeholders, including pedestrians. D. Prioritizing the maximization of vehicle throughput over pedestrian safety. Correct answer. C. Integrating continuous feedback loops from a wide range of urban stakeholders, including pedestrians. In the context of using AI for predictive policing, what approach should be taken to critically evaluate and mitigate risks of reinforcing systemic biases? A. Ignoring historical data to avoid confronting uncomfortable truths. B. Applying the same model uniformly across different demographics without customization. C. Performing rigorous ethical and impact assessments, considering socioeconomic and racial disparities in historical arrest data. D. Focusing exclusively on predictive accuracy as the sole measure of success. Correct answer. C. Performing rigorous ethical and impact assessments, considering socioeconomic and racial disparities in historical arrest data. For an AI system that moderates online content, what mechanism is crucial to balance between automated efficiency and ethical considerations? A. Implementing strict, non-negotiable automated decisions without human oversight. B. Allowing for human intervention in ambiguous cases to assess context and nuance. C. Exclusively using historical moderation decisions to train the AI, ignoring evolving societal norms. D. Disabling user reports and feedback to streamline operations. Correct answer. B. Allowing for human intervention in ambiguous cases to assess context and nuance. Considering an AI-driven environmental monitoring system, how should developers address the challenge of ensuring the system's resilience to unpredictable climate patterns? A. By strictly adhering to historical data without considering future climate projections. B. Relying on a single data source for simplicity. C. Incorporating a wide array of climate models and continuously updating datasets to adapt to emerging patterns. D. Designing the system with a fixed operational framework, resistant to updates or changes based on new environmental data. Correct answer. C. Incorporating a wide array of climate models and continuously updating datasets to adapt to emerging patterns. When developing a cross-border e-commerce recommendation AI, what strategy ensures it respects cultural differences and legal requirements across countries? A. Generalizing user preferences based on stereotypes. B. Deploying a uniform recommendation algorithm irrespective of local nuances. C. Tailoring algorithms to reflect regional legal standards and cultural preferences through localized data analysis and stakeholder engagement. D. Excluding non-English language data to simplify the development process. Correct answer. C. Tailoring algorithms to reflect regional legal standards and cultural preferences through localized data analysis and stakeholder engagement. For an AI system involved in automated loan approvals, what is a critical measure to ensure fairness across diverse applicant demographics? A. Using data from a single geographic location. B. Designing the system to disregard alternative credit data that could benefit underrepresented groups. C. Implementing a fairness audit to identify incorrect bias in decision-making algorithms. D. Assuming that the absence of explicit demographic information ensures unbiased decisions. Correct answer. C. Implementing a fairness audit to identify incorrect bias in decision-making algorithms. In an AI-driven project aimed at automating job candidate selection for diverse roles, How can the development team best ensure the system's decisions promote diversity and inclusion? A. By restricting the algorithm to evaluate candidates based only on traditional metrics such as years of experience. B. Ignoring the impact of socioeconomic factors on candidates' career paths. C. Including multifaceted performance indicators that reflect a broad spectrum of skills and backgrounds. D. Limiting stakeholder input to senior management perspectives. Correct answer. C. Including multifaceted performance indicators that reflect a broad spectrum of skills and backgrounds. An AI system designed for job recruitment unfairly prioritizes candidates from a specific geographic region due to biased training data. Which performance indicator directly addresses the mitigation of this type of bias? A. Enhancing the system's ability to process applications more rapidly. B. Implementing rigorous data cleansing protocols to ensure representativeness and accuracy. C. Increasing the transparency of the AI system to regulatory bodies. D. Focusing solely on the technical efficiency of the AI model. Correct answer. B. Implementing rigorous data cleansing protocols to ensure representativeness and accuracy. In the context of the AI development lifecycle, at which stage should an algorithmic impact assessment, AIA, be prioritized to evaluate and mitigate potential harms, especially when integrating systems in sensitive areas like criminal justice? A. During the initial planning phase to determine the project scope. B. After the deployment phase as part of post hoc testing. C. Throughout the model training phase to ensure unbiased algorithms. D. Before the development phase, when defining business objectives and requirements. Correct answer. A. During the initial planning phase to determine the project scope. Considering the EUI Act, how would a high-risk AI system's requirement for human oversight manifest in a real-world scenario involving autonomous driving technology? A. By limiting the operational domain to ensure safety. B. Mandating constant, real-time supervision by a human driver. C. Only requiring oversight during the software development phase, focusing solely on post-deployment incident reporting. Correct answer. B. Mandating constant, real-time supervision by a human driver. A multinational corporation develops an AI system to personalize user content across different regions. What aspect of AI governance should be prioritized to address the variations in norms and expectations across these diverse cultural landscapes? A. Standardizing content irrespective of regional differences. B. Developing region-specific AI governance frameworks. C. Prioritizing efficiency over cultural sensitivity in content delivery. D. Implementing a one-size-fits-all approach to privacy and data protection. Correct answer. B. Developing region-specific AI governance frameworks. In an AI system designed for predictive maintenance in manufacturing, which aspect of responsible AI governance is crucial to manage the risk of operational downtime due to unforeseen AI system failures? A. Focusing exclusively on maximizing predictive accuracy. B. Establishing a robust system for continuous model monitoring and maintenance. C. Limiting the AI system's functionality to non-critical machinery. D. Delegating all responsibility for system failures to the AI developer. Correct answer. B. Establishing a robust system for continuous model monitoring and maintenance. An AI-driven platform for loan approvals is being developed to ensure adherence to ethical AI principles. Which action is critical during the stakeholder engagement process? A. Excluding potential borrowers from the conversation to streamline development. B. Solely focusing on the financial institution's profit margins. C. Involving diverse groups including borrowers, financial advisors, and ethicists to evaluate fairness and transparency. D. Limiting feedback to the post-deployment phase to speed up the time to market. Correct answer. C. Involving diverse groups including borrowers, financial advisors, and ethicists to evaluate fairness and transparency. How should a company developing AI for facial recognition in security systems address the potential for discrimination and bias, particularly when applied in diverse urban environments? A. By restricting the deployment to high-security areas only. B. Implementing comprehensive testing protocols that include diverse datasets to minimize bias. C. Focusing on the speed and accuracy of recognition over ethical considerations. D. Limiting the systems used to daytime operation to ensure visibility and reduce errors. Correct answer. B. Implementing comprehensive testing protocols that include diverse datasets to minimize bias.